want to show you how you can make your own calendula oil for in the winter time when you don't have fresh calendula flowers, and if you have any cuts, abrasions, skin rashes, even diaper rash for kids. And it's really, really simple. All you're going to need is a good organic oil. Whatever you choose is fine. I'm going to use sunflower oil because it's pretty benign and most people don't have allergies to sunflower. You're going to need a couple of nice fresh calendula flowers just picked from your garden or from somebody who has a pesticide-free garden. Don't pick ones that have been sprayed with anything. You want a nice, fresh, organic calendula. I just had a little label that I did on my label maker saying calendula oil, and you want a little bottle. So all you're going to do is pick the petals off your calendula flower. You can just grab it like this and just literally pull them off. They come off in a big bunch, nice calendula leaves, petals, sorry. So just grab it like this, hold the green part, and pull. And oh, it has a lovely, lightly floral, citrusy kind of scent to it. So I'm going to chop them. You don't even need to chop them, but I'm going to chop them because it'll release more oil. So the hardest part is actually getting it down into the jar. So just chop them a little. That's all you have to do. And you can feel the oils. They actually stick into my fingers. And then you want to like wind them up enough so you can poke them down and stuff them into the jar. Don't need any special tools, just the end of a can opener here. So just stuff these into the jar, and then you can strain this off later if you want. You don't have to. I don't. But if you really want to, you can strain it later on. But you want it to sit for at least, if you want a nice heavy infusion, you want it to sit for at least, say, a month. So, nice clean jar, fresh organic calendula flowers, and just the color that it's leaving on the cutting board is amazing, and it has such healing properties. So that's it. Just fill your jar up with your calendula petals, like that, and pour your oil over top. Now you can use, like I said, I'm using sunflower oil. You can use olive oil, coconut oil, whatever kind of oil you want. And that's it. You're done. You have your calendula oil, which you'll infuse there. You want to leave it for about a month. You can use it before that. It just won't be quite as potent. That's it. You have calendula oil. Now you can add this to your bath. You can use this as a straight remedy if you have any kind of skin irritations or eczema. Or you can add it to your own homemade lotions, soaps, whatever you like. So that's it, pretty simple. Some flower petals and some oil in a bottle. I'll sit this actually in a warm spot, probably just there on the window ledge, and you'll see as the flowers break down, if you want to, at that point you can strain it into another bottle and at about a month, and it'll be a nice bright orange. This clear oil will look nice and orange with the calendula infused into it. So that's it. Make your own herbal oils. You can do it with pretty much any herbs. I'm doing it with the calendula today. Label them and put them in a window ledge and just let them sit, and the oil will take up all the oils from the calendula petals and make a beautiful healing oil that's all organic and cheap and easy.